Welcome back, everyone, to Cookie's Let's Playing XCOM 2. So, we just finished our second mission, and we're ready to go to our next mission, I assume. I don't think there's anything else pressing I needed to do before going on with it. Alright, so I've got 2 days to make contact over here. I believe some of these missions are going to be expiring soon, but that's okay because they've both got at least 100% infiltration rate. So the mission should be manageable. Recover item, extract VIP. Alright, and yeah, because I'm discovering a new region at the moment, I'm not actually generating any other missions in this thing. Advent Strength 1. Oh, okay. I should pay attention to that. Oh, I have a feeling the more successful missions I do, the harder these missions are gonna get. Yuck. Alright, well, luckily you've got the two larger teams handling these missions, so... return... mission expiring. Must launch robot. Oh, okay. No. Apparently no. I've straight got to go into this now. Because time passes on the overworld, so... view squad, return to Avenger... mission expiring, must launch or abort. Enemy readiness vulnerable, extremely light, I think... yeah, you know what? I'm just gonna go for this one. Nice little touch I noticed on the loading screen, so we'll hopefully see it on this one, is because... in the old one, you just immediately... I'll let this go. Extracting a VIP who had been providing reconnaissance data in this area. We've got the coordinates, but it's likely we'll have to clear out a contingent of hostile forces to make this work. Okay. Any soldier can equip a pistol. Okay, so I'd have to equip the pistol to the assault sniper that I was training if I wanted that pistol perk to be useful. Because it used to be that the snipers just automatically got a pistol. And they were the only ones that could equip it, you know, sort of a long-range sniper weapon, short-range pistol weapon. But yeah, before I got rudely interrupted, in the XCOM 2, you're always flying directly in and out of missions, so the loading screen would be in the Sky Ranger, but I like how, because of all this infiltration mechanic, they actually rather have the loading screen vanilla as the Sky Ranger. They've actually got, you know, the... people, remember this Long War 2, it's not like an official expansion or anything, this is actually a mod made by an incredibly dedicated team, and the amount of detail, the amount of extra gameplay that this mod adds, it's just really, they could charge this as an expansion, and I would happily purchase this. I mean, it is amazing in terms of just the content it adds. Anyway, so, while we're waiting for this load time... oh, come on, computer. No better than this. Come on. Come on. So, it looks like this is going to be another locate VIP, take VIP, get to exit. So, I'm going to be not going to be too shy with the grenades, and considering I'm going to have a lot of grenades, because I forgot to change the loadout at all on these guys, I'm going to have a lot of flashbangs, a lot of normal grenades, but no smoke grenades, so... I'm going to be... and because I know I can't get bodies from them, I'm just going to, like, blow everything up if I need to, because... even though the grenade rolls I've been getting are terrible, it's at least guaranteed to damage. Like, grenades, as far as I know, don't miss. And if I'm not getting any salvage from it, I might as well just blow them up. Alright, so... okay, it looks closer than the previous one. Target coordinates incoming. Secure the VIP and proceed to the evac volume for extraction. Alright, it looks a lot closer, but I don't think I'm going to get as much. Knows we're here, so your position isn't concealed for the extraction. Yeah, no concealment, 16 turns, reasonably far away objective. Although I still reckon that's closer than the previous one. Yeah, definitely. But the problem is I'm not going to have as much in terms of... Like, if I'm walking straight up this road, I'm going to have almost nothing in terms of cover options. And what's even worse, if I aim for cover this way and then the aliens burst sideways out the building, I'm going to be immediately flanked. So I think slow and steady is still going to win this race. But as long as I find the aliens on, say, my first turn or so, and then I don't move any further, my positioning won't matter too much, because as long as, you know, no one goes too far and aggroes a wave of aliens, I'll still be okay. It's only when I move a soldier too far, everyone else is taking their moves, and then I aggro aliens, then I'm in real trouble. So, I'm not going to worry too much about cover until I do spot some aliens. So I'm just going to move them up haphazardly.
That's affirmative.
Yep. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'll move you last. 6.
Understood. Moving out.
Oh, that was a really Irish accent. You can lag behind in full cover. Alright, and then everyone can just overwatch. Overwatch for everyone. Again, ideally I want the aliens to come to me, not the other way around. Alright, we'll move further forward. Is this full cover? Yep, okay. It's probably the next best place to move to. Alright, looks like I've still got a decent amount of cover for the next... It's a bit further away than I thought it was going to be. Still got plenty of time, so I don't need to rush yet. So I'll move everyone up to sort of this line. Yep, so I've got my line. As long as all my soldiers stay within that line, I should be able to move them up a little further. So they'll all move up this way, this way. Look, Ma, no cover. Clearly, whatever this soldier is, they are slow. So I'm going to have to spend an extra turn, and you can also move up to the next behind-ish full cover. Alright, everyone goes on Overwatch. Alright, so at least I know the aliens are going to be coming. So that orange cone is essentially me hearing where the aliens are. So that tells me at least I'm on the right track with thinking they're going to come at me full frontal. Oh, see, this is what I'm talking about. I don't have that much front on cover. I've got plenty of side on cover, but no front on cover. See, if I move here, I'm just going to aggro them. So, to give you an idea in terms of the range, blue shows me where I can move using only one move. To move another one is sprinting. And it immediately uses both my actions. Essentially, if I move to a bad spot while sprinting, I can't move for the rest of the turn, and it can really stuff us up. That being said, I do want to try and make it to this tree. So I think what I'll do is I'll try going here, see if I aggro anyone. Oh, that's even worse, because, you see, at least if I aggro someone, I could start putting together a plan to start shooting at them and taking them out. But now I've got to go that little bit extra. Okay. No! Now I gotta go that little bit extra and aggro the enemies. At least they're reasonably far away, so I've got some time on my hands. But I don't have any good cover to run to. Actually, cover this way should... it's too easy for him to just run over here and flank me, though. Yuck. I mean, I can fire at him from here. Actually, oh no, that's that one. Alright, well, look, I'll inch him forward as much as I can. So, I can't... Unfortunately, I won't be able to move everyone into a spot where they can actually start firing and being useful. But I can at least make sure they're all safe, and then see if I can go one step further after that. Probably should have moved her there. Oh well. Where are you? You're still not in cover. Oh, I can move you there. Excellent.
Affirmative.
Good job. 14 turns. Alright. Alright, let's see what I can fire on. Alright, it's probably best to get rid of these if I can. Alright, so who can fire at what? You can only fire at one, so I'll get you to fire at that one in particular. Okay, that's fine. Everyone else can fire at both? Okay. Let's go for a full kill of this one first. Yep, good. Good, we're on track.
I just hope that helped.
Alright, hopefully... miss, that was to be expected. Okay. Look, even if I don't kill this one, I think I'll still be okay. I would like to land at least one hit on it though, that being said. 65, okay, we good. We good. We good, right? Oh, come on.
Yeah, I didn't get it.
No kidding. Please don't do anything nasty. Yes. Oh, marked. That's going to make every other soldier's attacks on that particular soldier more accurate. Yeah. Okay, I'm glad he was wearing his vest, but he's now damaged, so he's going to take time to recover next mission. Alright, time to move forward with this. So I'm going to get a bit aggressive. Overwatch? Since when was he in Overwatch? Okay, so some of these soldiers, and I've got to start looking more out for this, some of these soldiers seem to already have the perk where even if you take a shot during your turn, you get to stay in Overwatch. Did he take a shot that turn? Yeah, he did. He damaged that guy. I can't believe these guys already have upgrades. Alright, someone needs to shoot that down, because I don't want that sticking around for next turn. Good! Excellent. Whoever you are, you're getting a... Does that kick me? Hold up. Can I zoom in? I'm pretty sure someone wrote kick me on the back of her armor. Excellent. Alright. Now, if I get right up in his face, I'll have a very good chance of killing him. I need to kill both of these guys at the same time. Alright, I'll see what he can do first. 16 and 10. Yuck. You know what? I'll do a flashbang, because even if I don't kill him, it means they're not going to be as accurate for the next couple of turns. Whatever voice pack that is, I'm actually quite enjoying it. Alright, what kind of firing can you give me? 24? I'm tempted to take it. I'm also tempted to just move up and shoot him. I've got 13 turns. Is that the building I need to climb? No, I've still got to get one more climb. Alright, I'll spend this turn playing it safe and taking whatever shot I can get. Next turn I'll get a bit more aggressive, but I still haven't killed him.
Every once in a while. You get it, Dad.
Is that Junkrat?
I'll check it out.
Alright, 16, 16. Can a grenade reach him? Ugh, learn to throw better. So you know what, I might as well just throw the grenade anyway. Guaranteed damage when I've got no body extraction anyway. Definitely worth it. 13, oh come on. You can give me a better damage roll than that, can't you? I thought we were friends. Okay. No, I'll keep firing after the officer. Yay! I mean, none of my 40 or 60% chance hit, but my 13% sure did! I'm sure someone, probably Alec, is going to tell me that's exactly how statistics work, or how probability works, but I don't care, dammit. Oh great, I've got no one else left to shoot with. It's okay, they're disoriented. That should buy me enough time for the moment. Still disoriented, still disoriented. Yep, that's good. Missed. Yep, that's good. Alright, time to get aggressive on these guys. I mean, right up in their faces. Alright. Who's going on the suicide run first? We have a volunteer.
That'll do.
Man, I want to change voice packs on everyone so I can use all my custom voice packs, but this Scottish accent is just... I'm on board. No. If I get here, I should be very close to flanking him, or at least have a decent angle on him. 32-24. Let's do 32. Yes, got him. Alright. One down, one to go, and then the other wave of aliens, which is inevitably going to be coming up soon. That is a 16. I'll try and move up.
You better keep me covered.
Still a 16. I'm gonna have to take it though, because he's not gonna stay disoriented forever. Missed.
I didn't hit anything. Running dry on ammo.
See, I don't think any of my troops are in particular trouble with where they are positioning. Oh, can I grenade him? Oh, come on. Come on. Wait. Did I get him? No. Great, I'm gonna have to take my chances. Come on, 13%. No.
Not even close. Got no ammo.
Alright, let's move you up there.
Good copy. Moving on target.
I'm not sure whether I should just leave him overwatch so he can't move, or try taking the 21. Oh, I'll put him in overwatch. Hopefully he'll be too spooked to move. Now he generally doesn't like me. Oh, I've still got one more person left! Excellent. They can't really move into a good position to shoot though. Can I move into any position to shoot without not being in cover? I don't think they can. Oh wait. What about upstairs? Nope. Alright, I guess I'll...
Okay.
Hopefully that's enough range? Yes it is. 30. Oh, that's actually pretty okay. It still didn't hit.
My weapon's bent.
Yep, removed. That was expected. He moved back. Okay, back is okay. Back is where I want him. Oh! Wow! Overwatch did it!
Enemy eliminated. Wow, would you look at that?
Alright, so now. Okay, so on my to-do list, step one is pick up that. Got 11 turns left, that's still plenty of time. Alright. Hair trigger. Step 2, reload everything. That definitely drained my ammo, trying to get those shots. Alright, so I think I'm free to move everyone out of cover again. As long as I don't move past this line, I won't aggro another wave.
Alright, I'm reloading this thing.
Reload, and I'll have you on overwatch. Just as a insurance policy.
On my way.
Reload.
Ready to go.
You can move up and reload as well.
Moving on target location. Oh yeah.
That's the VIP. Do I still have someone else to move? Yes, I do.
Good copy. Moving on target.
And you can move up to that full color cover. And hunker down. Alright. Still got 10 turns left. I'm at least halfway across the map. Fully reloaded. Oh, I've got to get that before that expires. So that's going to force my hand to move up anyway. So if I move there, he can be my scout. Scope.
Happy birthday.
Is that Junkrat? That might be Junkrat. Alright, now what's the easiest way to climb up that building? Looks like there's a ladder there. So I'm assuming there's gonna be some sort of ladder at least here. Don't see anything though. Alright, well look, anyway, I can move all my troops up to at least that point. 10 turns. Yeah, I think I can afford to take maybe one turn being cautious.
Move.
I can move you up there because you're a slow mover.
On my way.
Move.
Hi.
Hi. Overwatch.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Overwatch, Overwatch, Overwatch. Should be safe enough to move you up there. Okay, and Overwatch.
I'm watching for them. G'day, cover.
Alright, so the sound was coming from there, which makes me think my next wave is somewhere in this alley. So, where's my most forward soldier? Move you there. Right, do I see anything yet? No. Could also be in that building. Oh! Excellent. Okay, so I can see them, but I haven't aggroed them. That rarely happens. Okay, so I've just got three, looks like, run-of-the-mill advent troopers, plus anyone I can't see. They've got the high ground on me, which could be a problem. Hopefully they just stupidly run down that drain pipe. Right, now I've got to be careful where I move everyone, because I am right on the verge of aggroing them. But I should be safe if I go here. At least I know where they are, so I can all start planning my army. So I can use sideways cover effectively against them. So I'll move someone here.
Moving to position.
Move someone here. Move someone there.
Moving on target location.
Move you there. And move you there.
I hope you thought this through.
You watch.
I'm watching for them.
Affirmative. Covering
moving
nine.
To Overwatch.
You can keep hunkering down. Oh, did I end up? Oh, I wasn't paying attention and moved my VIP far too close. Or at least a lot closer than I would be comfortable with. Oh, nice little touch they have. Occasionally on these video screens, your soldiers' faces will pop up under their, like, most wanted list. Alright, are these guys still here? No, they've moved. Blew. Alright, move over here. Where did they go? Okay, they were definitely on that roof a second ago. Why have they disappeared entirely? Alright, 8 turns, and the extraction point is right there. I can definitely spend another turn being cautious.
Are you sure it's safe?
Please don't set off any alarms.
Rolling.
Alright, you stay there this time. You are always slow. Someone else I haven't moved yet. You. Yeah, we'll move you there. Because I'm reasonably certain they're somewhere over on that side of the screen. If they're moving around, hopefully they'll see me, and I'll just overwatch them to this on this turn. Overwatch them to death, rather. Can I go down? More overwatch. Alright, please run into me. Please spot me. Come on. Yes, thank you. Oh, I hadn't seen that sectoid before. I hope that means there's not more than one. Hey! See? Already dead. The beauty of Overwatch. Yeah, it's 4 damage on him. That's missed.
Come on, focus.
Missed.
Come on, focus.
Yeah.
Get it together.
Okay, I killed one, half health the other. That's still really good for Overwatch damage. Overwatch damage, pretty sure it's still the same as it was before, so there is a penalty for... Oh, can I move there? Oh, okay, this might actually... I'm gonna do some nice flanking strats here, I think. So Overwatch does come with a bit of an aim penalty, but as you can see, it allows me free shots if they move into me, rather than me moving into them. 26-18. I'll get rid of him, because that's one less enemy firing back at me. Although... Okay, for some reason I thought that was a confirmed hit, you know, 73%, seemed pretty safe. I'll move you up. Oh, that's the VIP! Oh, I thought that was a soldier. Oh, that's not gone well.
Order's confirmed.
I will probably just move her straight back then. 30... Might be worth throwing another flashbang. Gives me another turn to deal with them. That guy should be dead, because I'm going to have at least another 2 flanking shots on him. So there is no reason he should still be alive at the end of this turn. Yeah, move you there.
You better keep me covered.
Okay. Should be dead. Good.
I hope you're suffering.
Brutal. Okay. So now that he's dead, I feel a little bit safer using this angle for cover. Not sure I should get that close though.
Order's confirmed. Moving out.
Alright, 13 and 13. You know what? I'll keep...
On Overwatch.
Keep her on Overwatch. Yeah, and having someone on Overwatch just means that they're more likely to stay pinned down rather than move around and do whatever they want. I'm gonna try and get rid of that sectoid. No.
I got nothing. Talk me some ammo.
Do I move all the way back, or do I move behind here? She should be safe enough back there. Okay, what kind of targeting do I have from here? 10, that's not worth it. Grenade time? Can my grenade reach? Nope. Alright, it's not the greatest positioning, but at least this way. I'll be able to throw a grenade. Well, I'll see if it's worth shooting. No, it's still not worth shooting. Yep, kaboom kaboom. Yep, nice. Oh. Oh, thought it was about to, like, freeze and die on me for a second. Yeah, I'm good. So far I've only heard... What? Oh god, I forgot about reinforcements. Okay, so that flare means there's about to be a bunch of enemy troops dropped on my head, and I've only got 6 turns left. Alright, if I can spend just one... Alright, if I can just have one person to get rid of him, like with a grenade, and just have everyone else on Overwatch ready to... give a warm welcome to the reinforcements. Okay, so far this plan is working. They're gonna drop right on top of me, so... I should be able to get in a few good shots, so I'll move my VIP around out of the way. Also, she's got a very good chance of just, like, I think that based on what we saw with the prep level of last mission, there shouldn't be any more actual on the board waves. There'll only be these reinforcements coming in, and then I should be clear to just run to the exit. Oh, that's about to expire too. Alright, so I'm gonna have one less soldier actually focusing on the reinforcements, just because I want to pick up every resource I can. Because even if laser sight is a good upgrade, but even if it's not that great of a, you know, weapon mod or thing, it's, you can always convert it to currency. Alright, so now I'm just gonna, I might as well get into cover because that's not gonna make a difference. So essentially I'm just gonna have all these guys up close, pointing their guns, so as soon as the troops doing it, it's just open fire.
Moving to designated position. Got it covered.
So you can move just behind it here. Overwatch. Overwatch from there. Alright, let's see. What have we got in store? I hope it's no more than three enemies. Oh god, four and one of them's an elite. Alright, let's see what they do in terms of running for cover. Alright, let's see how many of them I can kill just straight off the bat. One, missed, killed, killed. Two, immediately killed, including the, what's his name? The captain. Alright, got five turns. Got some grenades. Think just grenading everyone at this point and running to the goal sounds like a good idea to me. Yep, perfect. Can I shoot him from high ground? Well, I might as well take a pot shot. I mean, she's well and truly out of the way anyway. Yeah, just throw another frag grenade. No need to get fancy with this. Just blow everything up. I know there was someone who still had a grenade. Yep. No, already tried grenading with you. Excellent. Alright, please die and allow me to run to the goal. You're most obliging, sir. Okay, there should be no problems with me just running everyone to the goal.
Double time.
Alright, you can just run straight to the goal. Okay, so at least the VIP is safe now. Okay, so you can run. Apparently, you can't run all the way to the pipe, so you can run. Let's turn this around. There.
Got it. Moving.
You can move there.
Okay, I'll go.
You can move there. You can move there.
That's affirmative.
Move up here.
I'm all over it.
Now, just in case, I'm not going to instruct anyone who's already at the zone. I'm just going to leave him there just in case I need to mop up a couple of last minute aliens. Overwatch. 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 Yeah, I'm just gonna end my turn. Yep, you can make it to the instruction point. And you can too. Excellent. Everyone's going home, only one injury, all mission objectives complete, picked up every item, killed every enemy, feeling good about life. And away we go.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Sweet. And with turns to spare. Alright, so I think 4 is too... Like, it was really good for infiltrating. But I think it was far too small of a squad size. Whereas with 6, I felt like I had enough squad to do it. I didn't actually... I was able to infiltrate enough, and I also had enough squad to deal with whatever came up. Like, I assumed that I didn't get any reinforcements on the 4 because I had infiltrated so well. So, I don't know. Still can't tell whether or not I want to have bigger squads or smaller squads, because it seems like the trade-off is pretty fair so far. But that'll probably change as the months goes on and I have to start taking smaller and smaller missions just to make sure I've got enough troops to go around. Like, recruiting and inducting more troops might actually be a focus.
I'm certainly impressed, Commander. Another heroic effort in the field.
7 days? Ugh. Because, yeah, in my previous XCOM run-throughs, again, being the absolute worst type of save scum, I, you know, never lost any troops, really, so I just, you know, oh, I have about 2 teams worth of troops at any one time, I don't need to bother training anymore, I don't need to worry about management, and... game is hard. Game is also very fun and interesting, though. Alright, so, new assault... New specialist, new grenadier, new shinobi, 2 shinobis. I might want to swap into a different team then. Reasonably certain at this point I want to keep the teams as balanced as I can, as opposed to sort of having a specialist. Specialists, you know, like, have all the close quarter combat on one and all the heavy weapons guys on the others. I think I still want to keep reasonably balanced teams, so I'll swap him with someone else, depending on what other things happen. And another grenadier? Ugh. So lucky grenades are so great at the moment. Otherwise I'd be reasonably annoyed with that. My irrational hatred of grenades. Hair trigger, laser sight scope, Mary Lee. More engineers, excellent. Really glad I spent all that money getting more engineers. Now I've got so many engineers, I don't know what to do with them all. Alright, you might as well clear out that alien machinery. So you'll notice it's got 2 slots for engineers. I can still start clearing it out with only 1 on board. It's just going to take extra long time, so 20 days. That's okay though, as soon as another engineer opens up, I'll start excavating with them, and that'll speed it up again. I don't have any other real use for the engineers at the moment, so I'm happy to have them just all clearing out the debris, because not only does debris give me more resources, like supplies and alloys just for clearing them, but planning where I'm going to build all of my rooms is going to come into effect because there's a lot of adjacency bonuses. So the more rooms I have, the more I can start pre-planning as opposed to being very reactive with what things I think. It's like, okay, I need to build this now. I don't have an optimal space for it, but I need to build it now or I'm going to be really behind. So this will give me more options in the long run. And yeah, I seem to have just lucked out on getting a bunch of engineers to start with. Alright, so, that's that for the moment. Still waiting for that to do. I don't think there's anything else in here. Right, I'm going to leave it here for this episode. These episodes look like they're going to be 40-minute affairs each. I just think there's no way at the moment that missions are going to come in any quicker than that. As much as I'd like to, you know, go to play fast, I've also, you know, cannot risk losing anything at this point. So, yeah, let me know what you think. Like this video, subscribe, share it with your friends, your family. Yeah, and I will be back for episode number, I think we'll be up to 6. Alright, thanks for watching.